Came up from scamming and swiping. Stew for my nerve, I'm trifling. Finna go call me a raptor. Ride a little bit like a bison. Bitchin' the boot, shawty look like she hiking. I'm taking a liking, y'all texting, I'm piping. Hey, you guys, what's Gucci? It's your boy, and Shay K-Dot, the first black Saiyan to ever arrive on this planet. I'm back here with another video. I got this Shazam trailer. This was our trailer, too. This shit's short. Man, that's how you know this movie's gonna be weak. But this movie is gonna follow the basic formula that all superhero movies of this past decade have been following, that lighthearted bubblegum, fruit stripes and bullshit, that rainbows and butterflies, goody-goody, corny comedy kind of bullshit. I will watch this film. I'll watch it, because it's Shazam, bro. It's Shazam. Now, the only thing that could be saving this movie, based on this trash-looking actor in this suit that I've seen, the suit doesn't look bad. The issue is the actor. The actor doesn't even fit the suit. Have you guys seen his neck on the suit? Man, that shit is weak, bro. That shit is weak. Follow boy on Twitter, follow him on Instagram. That shit is weak. His neck is so small and that suit is so big. They literally are putting extra padding for his padding on his suit. Like, you could have, come on, man. You got to at least build up to be like Henry Cavill. If Shazam is like directly like Superman in a way, same build but different demeanors. You should have got that Henry Cavill build. If you're trying to stand up with the Superman of this universe, the DCU, you need to be the same build as this guy. You guys need to both like have the same workout regimen. That's how it should have went. Zachary Levi, you're too small, man. You're too small in that suit. You look so weird in that suit. That suit, the suit is bigger than him. If you look at the neck guard is so big it doesn't even fit this dude. Look, I believe this movie's gonna make over 500 million. Regardless, this movie's gonna make over 500 million. When this movie drops, I already know this shit gonna be corny. I'm still gonna watch it because I'm, you know, there at least will be some action and a little bit of story, maybe some good moments from the actors, maybe. But I don't want to hear nobody saying, "Oh, this shit's corny." I don't want to hear nobody saying that. If you like so many of the superhero movies of this past decade, a lot of them, and I mean a lot of them. If you like the bunch of superhero movies of this past decade that do this formula of hitting you with serious stuff, comedy, serious comedy, serious comedy, serious comedy. We know what movies are talking about. I like those movies too. I like those movies. Now I'm just going to say it. If you like movies like Guardians of the Galaxy, if you like movies like Ant-Man 1, Ant-Man 2, Guardians 2, Iron Man 3, Iron Man 2, Thor 1, Thor 2, Thor 3, and you call this shit corny, bruh, I'm about to get on you. I'm about to call you hypocrite for that shit, because if you like that corny shit, bruh, like, by default, this corny shit gotta get a pass. I had to do the same with Aquaman, bruh, because I like some of the Marvel movies. So, we're gonna go ahead and we're gonna get into this reaction. You guys, please comment down below how y'all feeling. Let's go. Let's go. Shazam. Let me make that bigger for y'all. Y'all can see it. I like that chain. That's Goku. Let's go. Fuck.
Billy Bats. I choose you.
Hold up. Put that back. Too loud. Don't want to hit y'all. Don't want to blow y'all ears up. Let's go.
Billy Bats. I choose you. Say my name so my powers will become yours.
Damn. That nigga's flying, bro. He's not. That fight better not be weak.
Some of your finest beer, please.
He's so serious.
Lair. Yes. If you have a location like on a cliff, like a castle-esque type thing,
overlooking some water,
this shit splashing about to be on rocks and stuff, then we will take that.
Experience it in IMAX.
This shit about to be some Guardians of the Galaxy, Spider-Man Homecoming bullshit. Hey, those movies make money now. All you need to do to please the masses is comedy bullshit. It can be whack-ass comedy, too. It can be, because, you know, everybody has different sense of humor. It can be corny, weak-ass comedy. And you got it. This movie, I don't really care for it. I don't care how well it does, because this ain't the movie I'm checking for. Aquaman was solid. It was tight. Better, looks way better than this shit. Wonder Woman 84 is a real prize. We got that Joker film coming out. That shouldn't be coming out, but it's coming out. That Joker solo standard Elseworld film. If it's good, I feel like it's gonna be good. It's gonna be serious. Wonder Woman 84 is gonna be way more serious than Aquaman and Shazam put together. It's about to be litty. But Shazam, you know, it looks like it can have good action. Hopefully that villain can bring the perk, bring the pain. Hopefully it's not weak. But, see, it's films like these, bro. If this shit don't make money, I'll be surprised. I'll be fucking surprised. I'll really be surprised. Because not a lot of people know about Shazam. Then we got this upcoming Captain Marvel. Where I really feel like Shazam, the release date for Shazam, they should take that out of April. Because Avengers Endgame coming out. And Endgame going to take a bunch of that money. Because it comes out the same month as Shazam. They should at least postpone it until... They should do it a month earlier. They should do it the month before. Like, real talk. I don't think they should release it in April. Avengers Endgame gonna beat this regardless. It's gonna beat it regardless. Endgame's gonna beat this shit regardless. It's regardless. So, overall, this movie is gonna make over 500 mil. It's gonna make over 500 mil. I'm not gonna say it's gonna make a billion. I'm not gonna say it could make 700... 800 mil, and that's it. So if it do, that's a success anyways. If it makes over 500 million, like if it makes over 500 mil, we good. As long as it gets to 700, 800 mil, cool. Because a lot of people go by box office nowadays, which I don't usually go by, but the masses like to go by. Oh, if it makes a lot of money, it's a good quality film. Venom made a lot of money. Bumblebee made Bumblebee was trash. That shit didn't make no fucking money. How much did it make? Yeah. Okay, wait, I'm recording a video real quick. I'm about to be done in a sec. Damn, how much did Bumblebee... Let's see how much that trash Bumblebee film made. I gotta see how much that trash made. Bumblebee. How much did that trash make? 5.92%. Dang! Bumblebee was trash. 377 million. Okay, if it gets a really high rating on Rotten Tomatoes, it's not a good movie. If it gets a low rating on Rotten Tomatoes, it might just be a good movie. So, fuck. Rotten Tomatoes is smoking. This movie got 92%, but Aquaman has a, what, 70-something percent? Bruh, Rotten Tomatoes, that's why Rotten Tomatoes is irrelevant, bruh. They trash. 64%? And it made a billion? Shit, fuck Rotten Tomatoes. Rotten Tomatoes trash, bruh. Well, their score for Venom was very accurate. Shouts out Rotten Tomatoes for giving Venom that 30-something percent that it deserved. Because that shit was trash, my nigga. Venom was trash. That script made no sense. Bro, let me talk about Venom real quick. Bruh. It took a riot. This why this film, it takes one thing for this film to be bad and how bad the script is in the writing. It took riot 6 months to get to San Francisco, right? So for 6 months he was doing some bullshit, right? It took him 6 months to sneak onto a plane to get to San Francisco from San Francisco to Asia. When he can jump to different people's bodies, learn what they learn. So what, he couldn't find an airport or something? He didn't know how to get a flight. He didn't even have to get a flight. He could have just snuck onto the plane. He's a piece of goo. Just jump onto the plane. Or why didn't you just swim across the water? Swim all the way from Asia to San Francisco, right? Huh? You know, Venom swam across the water pretty fast, so what's up? Fuck, that shit's trash. Look, Shazam could be tight. Shouts out to all the, you know, DC fans. You guys, I ain't really checking for Shazam like that. I'll check it out and review it. Solely, this is going to be a film just for entertainment. Let's be real. Same thing, I go to watch a bunch of Marvel movies. Entertainment. Fuck the stories, because them stories be trash. I'm a bunch of them. Shouts out Winter Soldier. Shouts out Black Panther. Shouts out Civil War. Shazam is following in the steps of Iron Man 3, Guardians 1, Guardians 2, Ant-Man 1, Ant-Man 2, Thor 1, Thor 2, Thor 3, Avengers 2, Borderline Avengers 3. Avengers 1 is still tight. That's iconic. Yeah, just following in those norms. Just gonna go watch it for entertainment purposes solely. But you guys, if this movie surprises me, hey, I'll be happy. I'm gonna end this video there. It's your boy Kid Out, the first black super saiyan to ever survive on this planet. Go spread that peace, love, positivity. Doses.